Come in.
Hi, Mr. Jones. Hello. My name is Julie Yang. I'm a physician assistant student working with Dr. Smith. Okay. How are you today?
I'm doing good, thank you.
Are you comfortable?
Yeah, I'm good.
Today I'm going to be doing an abdominal exam, which should take about 20 minutes. Okay. And we're going to start off with some questions. Would you mind if I have a seat?
Sure.
Start off with a few questions. How is your appetite lately?
It's pretty good.
Do you have any difficulty swallowing?
No.
Have you had any type of abdominal pain?
No.
Any nausea or vomiting?
No.
How about any changes in your bowel movements?
No.
Any blood in your stools?
No.
Have you noticed any yellow discoloration in your eyes?
No.
Or on your skin?
No.
Have you felt bloated or swollen in your abdomen?
No.
Have you felt or noticed any masses in your abdomen?
No.
Do you experience any heartburn or burning sensation, like in your stomach area?
No.
Do you have any family history of gastrointestinal diseases or cancer?
No.
Do you have a history of gastrointestinal illnesses?
No.
Any abdominal trauma or surgery? Mm-hmm. Do you use any type of tobacco products or do you smoke?
No.
Do you drink alcohol?
No.
How about any illicit drugs?
No.
Do you take any prescription medications?
No.
How about anything over the counter?
No.
Any herbs or supplements?
No.
And any history of allergies to medications?
No.
How about to latex products?
No.
That concludes our questions. I'm going to go ahead and do your physical exam now. Okay. I'm going to go wash my hands. Normally, I would put my gloves on. I'm going to go ahead and make sure that you are adequately exposed.
Okay.
If you don't mind putting your gown downward toward your stomach. I'm going to evaluate your general appearance.
Okay.
A healthy male,
okay.
Well nourished. I'm going to take a look at your nutritional state.
Okay.
Your physique, you don't look underweight or overweight, but you're well nourished, mm-hmm. like was mentioned, and well built. I'm going to go ahead and take a look at your level of comfort.
Okay.
Seem comfortable. Mm-hmm. You don't seem to be in any distress. Your respiratory rate and effort is unlabored. You seem to be at ease.
Mm-hmm.
You're well perfused and nice and pink. I'm going to go ahead and look at your skin from head to toe.
Okay.
I see that you don't have any lesions or rashes. Or any type of ulcerations or discoloration.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to look at your extremities. I see that you don't have any nail abnormalities. You don't have any erythema or edema.
Okay.
You don't have any tremors or any type of discoloration there or cyanosis. Now I'm going to go ahead and inspect your stomach.
Okay.
But before I do so, if you can lay down with your legs straightened out. And arms at your side, relaxed. I'm going to look at the contour and the symmetry of your abdomen. I'm going to be looking to see if there's any abnormal protrusions or bulges or masses. I'm also going to see that there's no peristalsis.
Okay.
I'm going to go ahead and see that there's no scars or dilated veins or striae or any rashes. And everything looks good.
Okay.
We're going to go ahead and I'm going to place my stethoscope on your stomach.
Okay.
auscultate on all four quadrants. Okay. I'm going to place it, the diaphragm, on each of the quadrants, listening for its frequency, its pitch, and the quality. Okay. And I hear normal bowel sounds. And if it's indicated, if I suspected a tumor or inflammation, any type of infection, I would also be listening over the liver. Okay. Can you breathe in and breathe out? If I suspected any type of infarct or inflammation, I would also listen over the spleen. Can you inhale and breathe out? So I just finished listening to the hepatic, listening for the hepatic friction rub or the splenic friction rub.
Okay.
Now I'm going to go ahead and percuss. I'm going to tap on your each of the quadrants of your stomach,
okay,
abdomen. And we'll be hearing mostly tympanic with some areas of dullness, possibly. Okay, sounds good. We're going to go ahead now and percuss your liver.
Okay.
I'm going to go down approximately 3 in your midclavicular line around the 3rd intercostal space.
Okay.
I'm going to go ahead and percuss. And I'll be hearing more of a resonant sound. And I'm going to percuss it until I hear more of a dull sound.
Okay.
Just around about the 5th intercostal space. I'm going to go ahead and mark it if that's okay. Now I'm going to go ahead and go below your umbilicus, right at about the right lower quadrant, and I'm going to be percussing superiorly. And it's more of a tympanic sound. I'm going to percuss until I hear an area of dullness.
Okay.
Just about so. I'm going to measure the liver span. And I'm measuring almost 8 centimeters. Normally, the liver size is about 6 to 12 centimeters in the midclavicular line and about 4 to 8 in the midsternal line. Now I'm going to go ahead and percuss your spleen. I'm going to be looking at the left axillary line about the 6th intercostal space. And it should be tympanic. I'm going to ask you to breathe in. And it should continue to be tympanic. Now, if I noticed any type of dullness, that's when I would suspect that your liver, your spleen is enlarged, any type of splenomegaly.
Okay.
Now I'm going to be asking for a little bit of your assistance for the next part of the exam. I'm going to ask that you place your hand firmly midline in your abdomen. I'm going to go ahead and place my right hand on your other flank, and I'm going to tap one side of your flank. And I'm feeling for any type of transmission of the fluid wave, any type of fluid that I feel on the other side,
okay,
and which may suggest ascites if that was the case. Yours is negative. Next, I'm going to be doing a shifting dullness test. What I'm going to be doing is I'm from the umbilicus to the flank, I'm going to percuss down toward the flank, and it will be tympanic. Until there's an area of dullness.
Okay.
I'm going to mark that if that's okay.
Mm-hmm.
Now I'm going to ask that you roll over to your right side.
Okay.
And I'm going to go ahead and do the same. I'm going to percuss down until I hear the area of dullness. And it stopped right here. And in the area of dullness is the same. It hasn't changed since when you were supine. So your test is negative. If you had any type of ascites or you suggested any ascites, then your shifting dullness would have shifted over more to the dependent side further.
Okay.
Now I'm going to ask that you lay back down on flat on your back. And I'm going to be doing a just a superior reflex. Looking for the abdominal wing, I'm going to take a Q-tip. I'm going to just stroke it gently on all four quadrants, laterally to medially. And it would be normal if I saw slight involuntary movements near the umbilicus. I'm going to go ahead and lightly palpate all four quadrants away from the area of pain first.
Okay.
Do a light rolling motion. I'm feeling for any type of tenderness. Do you have any tenderness at this point?
No.
I'm feeling for any abdominal rigidity, any masses. That all feels good. I'm going to go ahead and palpate you a little deeply this time. I'm going to place my left hand and put my right hand over it and go a little deeper. Palpating away from the area of tenderness first, once again. Okay. Any tenderness there?
No.
Okay. And once again, feeling for any type of rigidity, any type of masses. Now I'm going to go ahead and palpate your liver. I'm going to place my hand behind posterior around the 11th or 12th rib. I'm going to place my right hand around the right lower quadrant. And I'm going to just ask that you breathe in. Trying to catch the edge of the liver. Okay. I'm going to go ahead and now feel under your right costal margin. And can you breathe in? And I'm going to be looking at the patient, seeing if there's any pain. You can breathe out. Any hearing for any gasps or a catching breath. And if I notice any of that, then it would be positive for Murphy's. I'll go ahead now and palpate for your spleen. I'm going to place my left hand over your left rib cage. And if the spleen is enlarged, it usually heads more toward the right lower quadrant. So I'm going to start from here. I'm going to go ahead and ask that you breathe in. Go right underneath the costal margin. Breathe out. Feeling for the spleen. I'm going to go ahead and palpate for your kidneys. Place my left hand behind your flank. I'm going to place my right hand right under the costal margin. I'm going to try to catch your kidneys. Go ahead, breathe in for me. Trying to feel the pulse of your kidneys. Okay, breathe out. And then just keep it exhaled. And I'm going to go ahead and try to catch that. Same on the other side.
Okay.
Breathe in. And breathe out. Trying to catch it. Normally, you would not palpate it very easily.
Okay.
I'm going to go ahead and palpate all four quadrants again for rebound tenderness. Please let me know if there's any type of tenderness when I press down or when I let go.
Okay.
Any pain?
No.
Any pain?
No.
And when I press on your left lower quadrant, if you had any pain in your right lower quadrant, that would be positive for Rawsing's, which you suggest appendicitis.
Okay.
And now I'm going to also feel for right lower quadrant, right one-third of the distance from the umbilicus to the ACIS, or the anterior superior iliac spine, and feel for that area specifically for McBurney's point. Okay. Any tenderness there?
Mm-mm.
Now I'm going to be looking to see if you have any hernias that are present. I'm going to look for your, I'm going to ask that you cough.
Okay.
I'm looking for any bulges, for any umbilical or ventral hernias. I'm going to go ahead and also ask you to cough one more time. Looking for your femoral hernia.
Okay.
At this time, we're going to be doing some special tests. You can go ahead and put on your gown.
Okay.
And I'm going to go ahead and just bring the gown and the sheet up a little bit. I'm going to be doing the psoas sign.
Okay.
I'm going to be asking that you raise your leg against my hand, against resistance. And I'm going to be seeing if you have any pain. Any pain?
No.
And I'm going to go ahead and do it one side, but normally you would do it on both sides. Now I'm going to be doing the obturator sign. I'm going to ask that you flex your hip and flex your knee at a 90-degree angle. I'm going to internally rotate and externally rotate, feeling for any resistance. Do you have any tenderness?
No.
And if there was any tenderness at that point, that would be positive for obturator. When we do that test, it stresses the obturator muscle, which would also irritate the inflamed appendix.
Okay.
I'm going to be doing that on both sides,
okay,
typically. Now I'm going to be doing the heel tap. I'm going to go ahead and raise your leg just a little bit, about 5 degree angle. I'm going to strike your heel gently. Any pain?
No.
And that's negative for the heel test. And once again, if there was tenderness there, that would suggest any type of irritation or inflamed appendix. Now I'm going to ask that you sit up for me. Okay, I'm going to do your costra for tibial tenderness. I'm going to feel for that. I'm going to place my hand once again in a lumbar close to your about the 12th rib. I'm going to strike. Feel. Is there any tenderness there?
No.
Strike it gently with my hand, both sides. Any tenderness?
No.
And that would be negative for costra for tibial tenderness. Now I'm going to go ahead and do the rectal exam and take the stool guaiac test.
Okay.
And that concludes our abdominal examination.
Okay.
Do you have any questions?
No.
You can go ahead and get dressed.
Okay.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.